Erica. You shouldn't play with it. It's dangerous. Okay, are you ready? Mummy and I met many, many years ago in a place called Delphi House. She was a nurse, and I was a doctor. At night, we'd tell each other stories. She'd tell me about the future. Wonderful things. Things only she could see. I tell her about the past, about a great priestess marked with a butterfly who could stare into the fire and see the future. I used to tell her she was magic, just like the priestess. I think you're magic too, but you're gonna have to prove it. Pick your photograph, pick your favorite. Close your eyes, focus your mind, and conjure the power of the ancient priestess. Now find your mom again. See if you can guess where your favorite is. Disaster. Don't worry. I still think you're magic. She'll always be with you. Remember that. Even though she isn't here, she's still a part of you. If you could stare into the fire and see the future, what do you think you'd see? Thank you.
Buddha.
Do you need any help?
Miss Mason, I'm Sergeant Blake, the lead investigator on this case. Can I see that? I promise I'll give it back. You draw this a lot.
It's Greek, isn't it? The Delphic Epsilon. Same as with your father.
How do you know that?
I read your father's file. I had to. The hand belonged to a Kal Jahar. He worked at Delphi House. I believe you visited there with your father. Yes, he was one of its founders. Along with a man called Lucien Flowers. Mr. Flowers might be a target too. Look, we're keeping watch over at Delphi House. Protection detail. I'll be leading the investigation from there. Right now, it's the safest place for you too.
Thank you.
They're probably out for a smoke. Wait here, I'll go check.
What are you doing? Put that down. It's not yours. There's no note. No record of her anywhere. Right.
Well, that was a waste of time. I see you found someone. I guess I should have just stayed put.
I saw some girls. They were wearing masks.
Yeah. I'll check it out. I think it's some kind of therapy.
Who are you?
I'm Sergeant Blake. I'm leading the investigation. I'm supposed to meet a Dr. Ballard.
I can only apologize. We're all a bit nervous here. Sergeant Blake, I'm Rosa Ballard. I suppose you already know the Chief Inspector?
Sir, this is Erica Mason.
I'm sorry we're meeting in such difficult circumstances. Is there anything we can do to make you feel at home?
It's okay. I'm sorry too.
Come on. I'll show you the way. I suppose you don't remember me. I worked with your father. I used to look after you when you were little.
You knew my parents?
Of course. Your dad taught me everything I know. And your mum, she was incredible. Brilliant nurse, so smart, funny. Anyway, this is you. You might recognize it. Mr. Steinbeck, the night manager, will be downstairs if you need anything.
Hello.
Look under the bed. Uncle Lucy got you something. It should keep you out of trouble. Just like you.
Kirsty, I said you could help, but if you're going to be cleaning, I need to be here with you. No cleaning without supervision.
Death Wish. Over here. Don't mind her, she's got emotional problems.
Hurry up and die, Hannah.
She seems nice.
Yeah. But it's not her fault. I blame society. Here, take a seat, let me show you something. See this bit? It's simple. Four notes. Bum, bum. Bum, bum. I'll do the rest.
What are you doing?
Here we find.
mind.
No.
Don't.
No,
you don't can't. You dare.
It's not allowed.
Kirsty. Kirsty, calm down. Calm down.
Sergeant Blake's here. Needed in the main office.
Come in. My God. Erica Mason. You look just like your mother. Last time we met, you could barely see over the desk. I'm Lucien Flowers. I set this place up with your father.
It was a long time ago. I don't really remember.
I don't blame you. I can barely remember yesterday. Did you sleep okay? I know the old place can take a bit of getting used to.
It's quite intense.
The girls can have some difficult days, but we do good work here. I wouldn't trade it for the world. I hope you don't mind, but I brought you something. It was your father's. Your mother gave it to him on their wedding day. I just kept hold of it.
Hey. Sorry about that. I was just getting an update from forensics.
Erica, it's extremely likely whoever killed your father killed Mr. Johar. There may be some other victims as well we don't know about.
Are you sure?
There's no public appeal. Nothing in the press. The chances of this being a copycat are extremely low. Honestly, we don't have much to go on.
But Mr. Flowers has a suggestion. It might help you remember the face of your father's killer.
I was just a little girl.
Right. You're older now, stronger.
It's like therapy. It was developed by your father. It's completely painless. Perfectly safe.
Okay. I'll do it.
The images you're going to see are designed to relax you and open up your mind. Your father designed regression therapy to help our patients face their trauma. The first one is just a test. When you see it, just say whatever comes into your head.
Leo?
Okay, great. If you remember anything important, just write it down. I know revisiting trauma can be difficult, but you're perfectly safe. Let's begin.
Nature. Faith. Food. Warmth. Stab.
Tame. Animals.
Oh,
has always been you.
Time. Why did you draw her, Erica? Why did you draw your mother?